वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स टू आवर न्यू यूट्यूब चैनल फार्माटेक द डिवीजन ऑफ एक्सलेंस। सो इन द लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी सी द ऑटोकॉइड्स, इन दैट वी सी द टाइप्स ऑफ ऑटोकॉइड्स एंड आल्सो हिस्टामिनिक एंड एंटी हिस्टामिनिक एजेंट्स इन फर्स्ट जनरेशन एंड सेकेंड जनरेशन। देन इन द पार्ट टू वी सी द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ 5HT रिसेप्टर्स, and the 5HT receptors are classified in 5HT1, 5HT2A/2C, 5HT3 and 5HT4. The 5HT1 receptors are classified in two types, the 5HT14 and 5HT12/1D. The 5HT14 are presynaptic autoreceptors and it modulates the release of serotonin, and they are partial agonist of these receptors. Buspiron, isapiron, J-pyrone are useful as anti-anxiety drugs, and the 5HT12/1D it causes constrictions of cranial blood vessels, and they are the agonist at this receptor. Sumatriptan and naratriptan are useful for the treatment of acute migraine attacks. So the next is 5HT2A/2C. These receptors are responsible for most of the direct actions of serotonin. The ketanserin and myanserin agonists are useful as antihypertensive agents. The clozapine and risperidone are atypical antipsychotics. So the next is 5HT3 receptors. They are ionotropic receptors. All other 5HT receptors are G protein coupled receptors. It mediates most of the reflex and indirect actions of serotonin. Its stimulation is responsible for vomiting induced by anti-cancer drugs. The antagonists like ondansetron, granisetron and tropisetron are the agents of choice for chemotherapy induced vomiting. Then the last is 5HT4 and is present in GIT, that means gastrointestinal tract, and is responsible for the increase in peristalsis. And the agonists like sisapride, mosapride, menzapride are useful in the treatment of gastroesophageal reflux diseases. So next we see the non-selective drugs. The first is cyproheptadine. The cyproheptadine, it blocks 5HT2A and H1 and muscarinic receptors. It increases appetite and can be used in children to promote weight gain. The second is methisirgid. The methisirgid, it is a 5HT2A/2C antagonist and a 5HT1 agonist. It is indicated for the prophylaxis of migraine attacks, but prolonged use can result in pulmonary, endocardial and retroperitoneal fibrosis. So the next is non-selective drug is LSD. So LSD, it is an ergot derivative and a powerful hallucinogen. And the LSD is a powerful hallucinogen, and it acts as an agonist at several serotonin receptors, including 5HT1A. Then next, and also in 5HT2A/2C and 5HT5/7 receptors. So next we see the ergot alkaloids. The ergot alkaloids, these are derived from a fungus Clavis purpurea. So the ergot alkaloids derived from fungus Claviceps purpurea, it is the most important question in GPAT. So the ergot alkaloids are important compounds are ergotamine, ergometrine, ergotoxin, bromocriptine, dihydroergotamine and methisirgid. These drugs are only alpha blockers that can cause vasoconstriction due to their partial agonistic activity on alpha and 5HT2 receptors, maximum with ergotamine. Hydrogenation of the compounds decreases alpha agonistic activity, increases the alpha blocking potential. Therefore, dihydroergotamine even little vasoconstricting activity. Ergotamine activities can cause dry gangrene of hand and feet as well as coronary disorders. So the ergotamine and dihydroergotamine are useful for the treatment of acute attack of migraine. These are contraindicated in patients with ischemic heart disease due to their propensity to cause coronary vasospasm. So the next is dihydroergotoxin, also known as cordegocrine, and the dihydroergotoxin is useful for the treatment of dermatitis. So the next one is bromocriptine. It is useful in Parkinsonism and hyperlactinemia and in acromegaly and also in hyperprolactinemia. The bromocriptine is useful for Parkinsonism, hyperprolactinemia and acromegaly are the most important for GPAT, the bromocriptine drug, and it's useful for various diseases. So next is methisirgide is useful for the prophylaxis of migraine attacks. So the next is migraine. So migraine, it is a unilateral pulsatile headache due to dilation and inflammation of the affected cerebral vessel. Mild and moderate attacks are usually controlled by NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, whereas several attacks require ergot alkaloids or triptans for termination. The ergotamine are oral sublingual or dihydroergotamine parenteral can be used to abort acute attack of migraine. Caffeine enhances the absorption of ergotamine and is powerful vasoconstrictor, and it is usually combined with ergotamine. These drugs, however, increase the nausea and vomiting during migraine attack. The next one is sumatriptan subcutaneous. It is the drug of choice for aborting acute attack of migraine. It acts as a selective agonist of at 5-HT1B/1D receptors. It also suppresses the vomiting of migraine. It is a short acting drug, and other less useful drugs are zolmitriptan, eletriptan, naratriptan and almotriptan. All the drugs can cause coronary vasospasm and are contraindicated in ischemic heart disease. The triptans and ergotamine should be administered within 24 hours of each other. So the for patient with history of coronary artery disease, that means CAD, triptans or ergotamine are contraindicated. Therefore, opioids like intranasal butorphanol should be used for acute severe migraine. The butorphanol should be used for acute severe migraine. The prophylaxis of migraine is required if the attacks are frequent, less than 2 to 3 months. The drugs used for prophylaxis are propranolol is the most commonly used drug for prophylaxis of migraine attacks. Then next, timolol, atenolol, metoprolol and nodalol can also be used, but the drugs with ISA, example pindolol, are ineffective. The calcium channel blockers like flunarizine, it blocks Na plus channel, is also effective. The methisirazide, cyproheptadine and tricyclic antidepressants like amitriptyline can also be used. The clonidine can be used orally for the prophylaxis of migraine attacks. The topiramate anticonvulsant drug, it has recently been approved for prophylaxis of migraine. The valproate and gabapentin also possesses some prophylactic activity. Then next we see the prostaglandins. The prostaglandins and thromboxanes are synthesized from arachidonic acid. That means arachidonic acid, and it obtained from membrane phospholipids due to the action of phospholipidase A2 with the help of enzyme cyclooxygenase, also known as COX. It classified in three types, the COX1, that means cyclooxygenase 1, इट इज कंस्टिट्यूटिव एंड इट ऑलवेज प्रेजेंट इन सेल्स एंड इन सर्व हाउसेस कीपिंग फंक्शन एग्जाम्पल्स गैस्ट्रो प्रोटेक्शन एंड द सी कॉक्स टू दैट मीन्स साइक्लोऑक्सीजनेस टू आर इंड्यूसिबल दैट मीन्स सिंथेसिस स्टिमुलेटेड बाय एंडोटॉक्सिन्स एंड अदर इन्फ्लामेटरी मीडिएटर्स इट पार्टिसिपेट्स इन इन्फ्लामेशन एंड इट कॉन्स्टिट्यूटिव इन ब्रेन इंडोथिलियम एंड किडनी द नेक्स्ट इज COX3 दैट मीन्स साइक्लोऑक्सीजनेस 3 and is recently isolated from cerebral cortex and it involved in pain perception and fever and it is not involved in inflammation and paracetamol target COX-3 the cyclooxygenase acts and arachidonic acid to produce cyclic endoperoxide PGG2 by PGH2 in the cells further Fate of these compounds depend on the presence of different enzymes in the cell. Platelets contain thromboxanes synthetase and result in the production of TXA2, whereas the vascular endothelium contains prostacyclin synthetase and thus produce PGI2 and the various cells contain enzyme isomerase and can convert cyclic endoperoxides to PGD2 and PGE2 and PGF2N and PGF3N and corticosteroids inhibit the enzyme phospholipase A2 by inducing the production of lipocorticins. NSAIDs decreases PG and TX production by inhibiting cyclooxygenase inhibitors. Then next, so here is the complete We complete the second part of the autocoids. So stay tuned for the next third part for autocoids. So in the third part, we see the actions of autocoids in various sites of organs. That means CNS, CVS, platelets and uterus and other organs. So Here is the second part complete in this video. So hope you like this video. Please, if you like this video, please comment and please like, share and subscribe to our channel. And also please share this video to more and more to your GPAT aspirants as well as CET aspirants. So thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned for this video for third part. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Stay tuned. Welcome students to our new YouTube channel PharmaTech, the division of excellence. So in the last video lecture, we see the autocoids in that we see the types of autocoids and also histaminic and antihistaminic agents in first generation and second generation. Then in